Good morning, everyone. We are Rohit Super Girls.
My name is Divya.
And my name is Deepika.
So today, we are going to give an introduction about Bhagavad Gita. Deepu, what do you know about Bhagavad Gita?
Bhagavad Gita is the holy books of Hinduism. It was written about 5,000 years ago as a part of Mahabharata. Akka, can you tell me the main message of Bhagavad Gita?
Okay, I'll tell you about Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita was said by Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna gave the message of love and peace. Krishna tells Arjuna how he should complete his duties and become a part of the ultimate soul.
And yes, it also tells us how we should be in our life.
So, now we are going to tell few slokas on 6th chapter with meanings. Deepu, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha Atha Sasto Dhyayaha Atma Samyama Yogaha.
Let's start 6th chapter, the Yoga of Meditation.
Shri Bhagavanuvacha Anashritah Karma Phalam Karyam Karma Karotiyaha Sasanyasi Cha Yogi Cha Na Niragnir Na Chakriyaha.
Meaning, someone who performs activity that needs to be done without fixating on the results is a true yogi and a sage, not someone who merely stops performing all external or internal activity.
Yam sanyasamiti prahuhu yogam tam vidhi pandava nahya sanyasta sankalpo yogi bhavati kaschana.
Meaning, O son of Pandu, know that what is talked about as renunciation is the same as yoga. No one becomes a true yogi without renouncing the desire for results to action.
Arurukshor munir yogam karma karana muchyate yoga rudhasya tasyaiva samah karana muchyate.
Meaning, equanimous activity is the means to climb on the path towards yoga. Once someone is established in yoga, renunciation is the means to liberation.
Sarvam Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.
Thank you so much.